Good morning, everybody. We got Bridgehampton School. My name is Nigel Abercrombie, if you don't know. Today, well, I'm starting a new segment on trains. Today, we're going to be talking about steam trains, particularly the Long Island G5S S10-wheelers. Before we talk about the G5S 10-wheelers, let's talk about when the first steam train was invented. The first use of steam in transportation, traditional use on rail, it dates back to 1804 with a British guy named Richard Trevithick, who invented the first steam locomotive. The main job of that steam locomotive in its early days was to deliver steel. Trevithick's creation was scrapped. But they never made it into preservation. However, what does survive today is the oldest commuter railroad, the Long Island Railroad. Came around in 1834. First major locomotive that it had would be the G5S steam locomotives from 1923 to 1955. The G5S steam locomotives were Pennsylvania Railroad designs. 5S's were numbered 20 to 50 and were 10 wheelers, having a total of 5 axles. Two G5S's survive today, 35, which is in Oyster Bay, currently being restored to cosmetically fully restored by the Rare Museum of Long Island in Riverhead. Next time, I'll be reviewing Pennsylvania Railroad I-1SAs. See you later.
Ridge in the School, Mr. Barker here, back for WBEE Virtual Radio. Happy Friday, everyone. We made it through another full week. We have a special new segment taking the primetime Friday slot today, Nigel's Train History 103, where Nigel is giving us some history about one of his favorite hobbies, model trains. Man, we love when students share their passion and talents on the announcements. Great job, Nigel. Today is Friday, May 6th. It is a B-Day. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
The funny part about it.
Yeah, yeah. All right, ready? Everyone say it.
It is Mr. Pig Friday. Celebrity Mr. Pig is closing out our pledge today. Let's check in with our weekend forecast. And can you tell that I'm excited for the weekend?
Thunder.
Aw, man, it is looking like a rainy weekend, but you never know because the weather hasn't been the most accurate these days. So hey, here are announcements for the day. Last call for the Bridgehampton Summer Camp. Registration closes today. Yes, today it is free for Bridgehampton students and is open from pre-K to 6th grade. And there is a poster slash program art cover contest for the upcoming spring play. If you are an artist and want to design the poster slash program cover, draw it by hand or virtually and submit it to Miss Sanchez by Friday, May 13th. That is 1 week away. Here is the theme. The play is about brothers and sisters and all the fights and craziness that they get into. Sounds fun. Happy designing. And I hope you know now, but it is Mother's Day this Sunday. We honor and celebrate all our mothers out there and the incredible role they play in society. If you are looking for a thoughtful gift, there is a special Mother's Day plant sale by room 111, and get them while they are extra green. And the Hampton Library is hosting a sneaker drive today and tomorrow. They are asking for gently worn, used, or new sneakers to be donated in part of the Bridgehampton Half Marathon and 5K tomorrow. If you have any questions, you can contact the Hampton Library. And lastly, on May 6th, it is International No Diet Day. What a perfect coincidence on a weekend. Celebrate by eating your favorite sweet. I'll be having 2.5 double stuffed Oreos for dessert tonight. Go big or go home. All right, that's it for our announcements for the week. We are going to turn up that birthday music because we have a special senior's birthday. We have special guest Darth Vader and the Vitamin A Stormtrooper Orchestra helping us with this birthday. We want to say a very happy birthday to Sebastian Meir, who's in 12th grade. Happy birthday, Sebastian. I hope your birthday is filled with lots of Star Wars. From WBEE Virtual Radio, this is Mr. Barker signing off. Until Monday, have an amazing weekend, Bridgehampton family. You deserve it. Take it away.
And participate. And make sure to wash your hands with web soap. Put your mask on if you like to. And please stay safe.